Next up, Highland rice farming, presented by Sungjin.
I'm Sungjin Choe. Our solution is highland rice farming. The deltas and coastal areas classified as lowland rain-fed are inevitably facing climate change and sea level rise. This region accounts for 19% of world rice production. Many studies have warned us time and again that climate change and sea level rise will put the region's rice production at risk within a decade. And it's actually moving beyond what they anticipated. So this situation should begin bold adaptation measured to support the region's livelihood and 9 billion people by 2050. Rice is not an aquatic plant, although rice has long been grown in water. Then why do we grow rice in water? Without water, the most populous aerobic weeds dominate the field, and it's difficult to harvest. In general, when growing rice in water, 3 tons of water per kilogram of rice is inevitable. To make matters worse, growing rice in water exacerbates climate change due to massive methane emissions. To improve this situation, we've invented new rice farming technology called seed film cultivation. It grows rice outside the water, weeding by biodegradable film. Seed film cultivation is a technology convergence of biodegradable film and newly invented machines. The seed attacher attaches seed to biodegradable film and makes seed film. The mulcher spreads out the seed film and covers the seed film with soil. These machines replace traditional rice farming processes, including seedling cultivation, trench plantation, and weed control. What is the highland? It includes cornfield, wheat field, upland rain-fed, which shall not be affected by sea level rise. Highlands are everywhere near the rice paddies affected by sea level rise. Moving one meter from the existing rice field can prevent the damage from sea level rise. Highland rice farming with seed film cultivation doesn't require irrigation facility such as dams, reservoirs, and waterways. Liver water. Please take a look at this picture. It was a wheat field until last year. It was a rice paddies 20 years ago. But when the water was scarce, farmers began to grow wheat. Now farmers are very happy to grow rice again for the first time in 20 years. Seed film cultivation has some drawbacks. It requires new machines and $500 of biodegradable film. However, it can produce more than 6 tons of paddy rice in the highland without irrigation facility. So seed film cultivation is cost-effective. Our revenue model consists of machinery and material sales and rice sales. Rice sales are a marketing strategy through smart consumption. Consumers need to know that in lowland rice farming, huge water use and methane emissions are inevitable. This will help reduce damage from sea level rise and reduce methane emissions. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Judges. Questions?
In this particular slide here, you draw attention to, it appears there's a reduction in the use of hazardous chemicals. So your seed film, does it eliminate the requirement for pesticides or maybe not pesticides, but weed killer?
Yes. Biodegradable film prevents the weeds and also many rice disease from rice farming occur mainly in wet field. Seed film also reduce dependency on pesticides and fungicides.
Can you explain to us the connection to the coastal community and coastal community resilience?
Mekong Delta, for example, Mekong Delta has lowest rice production cost in the world. Rice production cost is about $800. And the price of the paddy rice is $250. Less than 3 tons means farmers lose money. $800 and $250, 3 times $750. Less than 3 tons, farmers lose money.
So the coastal community really, it's moving from being in the water to just inland a little bit, right? It's still,
yes.
So is it essentially staying in the community in some areas where there's farming, if it's a farming community? You're just moving inland?
Both of them. To maintain rice production, world rice production, the equivalent amount of rice must be produced in the highland.
You show the picture of the farm where this has been piloted. What's your plan for the next 6 to 12 months to scale this project?
We have no official data on this matter, methane, labor, and water saving. So we want to evaluation project with authoritative institute. And also we want to expand our business to other developing country or Middle East.
Can you how does the yield from the use of the of this particular technique compare to traditional methods?
There is three main reasons. First, rice is not an aquatic plant. Without water, aerobic condition of soil proliferate root and leads to high yield. Second, biodegradable film prevent the loss of moisture and fertilizer and also control weeds. Third, the yield of the direct sowing is higher than trench planting because the tillering point of direct sowing is closer to surface, so the higher than trench planting. Sorry.
Thank you very much.